Today, NASA held a press conference detailing a pair of discoveries made at both Europa and Enceladus. One of them gives us a potential way to more easily study the subsurface ocean that is believed to lie beneath the ice of Europa, and the other gives an extraordinary insight into the habitability and conditions in the ocean at Enceladus. In the press conference, NASA scientists announced that they had used a mass spectrometer on board the Cassini spacecraft to measure the chemical makeup of the plumes that Enceladus emits. These plumes are believed to originate from the ocean below. Within the plumes, they found hydrogen. This has far-reaching implications for the habitability of that ocean. Firstly, hydrogen can be used by microbes as an energy source. They can combine dissolved carbon dioxide in the water, which is also seen to be present in the data, with hydrogen in a process called methanogenesis due to the byproduct being methane, which is also present in the data as well as ammonia. The presence of these, however, do not necessarily indicate life, and as it turns out, there may be a huge insurmountable challenge to the idea of Enceladus currently hosting life, more on that in a minute. But it does mean that the chemical energy needed to support life is there, and while they have not yet detected sulfur and phosphorus, they have found all of the other elements needed for life at Enceladus. Given the models of the makeup of Enceladus that we have, it does seem likely that sulfur and phosphorus will eventually be detected. Another interesting finding made by the mission regarding the hydrogen is why it's there. The best explanation is that the water is reacting with the hot rocks of the ocean floor and thereby producing it. There's no way to know yet, but one way this could be happening is through the presence of white smokers, similar to what we find at geothermal vents in our own ocean. These are rich abodes of life on Earth, and could also be at Enceladus. But there's a few problems. A 2016 paper, links to all of the papers relevant to this video in the description below, presents that Enceladus and the inner moons of Saturn might not be that old and only formed about 100 million years ago. If that's the case, then it's unlikely that life is present in the subsurface ocean. It may have everything it needs to get going, but it just hasn't had enough time to arise. This is seemingly backed up by one aspect of the research released today. Enceladus has a significant amount of food, so to speak, for life there. So much so that they were able to calculate a calorie count of sorts. It's got plenty of food, and that could indicate that the reason for that is because nothing is eating it. And that brings us to the second discovery announced today. To study a subsurface ocean, you need access to it. That's easy at Enceladus because its plumes are currently spraying material at all times. This is not the case with Europa, even though it's thought that the surface is very active with ice possibly subducting under other ice similar to a tectonic plate. It's so active, in fact, that the place has almost no craters. That sort of constant intermixing of surface material with the ocean is interesting to say the least, especially where life is concerned. But we now seem to have strong indicators that plumes do indeed crop up at Europa fairly regularly. Using the Hubble Space Telescope, another team found indicators of an intermittent plume emanating from the same spot on Europa, which appear to be cracks. Further, when they looked at data from thermal maps made by the Galileo spacecraft years ago, they found that the same area is significantly warmer than the surrounding areas. While not yet set in stone, this strongly indicates that the plumes exist, and that gives us the opportunity to study their composition much like Cassini studied those at Enceladus by having a spacecraft fly through them. Just such a spacecraft, the Europa Clipper, is in development and will be equipped with a highly advanced mass spectrometer that is sure to reveal much about the composition of those plumes. Now, there is one last aspect of this that's worth including in this video. About a month ago, I released a video on this channel entitled A Detection of Life on Europa and an Enceladus Update, link in the description below. In it, I detailed a potential chemical detection of life on Europa due to the coloring present at some of the cracks in the ice on that moon. Now, no such coloring is present at Enceladus, suggesting that different chemistry is going on in these oceans. It's unknown why that is, but while Enceladus may be too young for life, Europa is over 4 billion years old. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently with a new book coming out. It's called Supermind, and much like my videos, it's based in solid science and concepts rather than fantasy. Look for it in just over a month, and be sure to check out my other books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.